الله الحمد لله وثناء لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. My respected brothers and sisters, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for yet another opportunity that we remind ourselves what is good for our deen, dunya and akhirah. Today we have an ayah which says, فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. What is your opinion about the Lord of the universe? And this question, Ibrahim alayhi salam asked his people, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrates in the ayat that come before this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّ مِنْ شِيَعَتِهِ لَإِبْرَاهِيمَ. And indeed, their example is the example of Ibrahim. إِذْ جَاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. When he subjected or he came to his Lord with a very pure heart. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ مَاذَا تَعْبُدُونَ. When he asked his father, and indeed his people, he asked them this question, what are you worshipping? Because he saw them worshipping idols and said, Aifkan alihatan dunallahi turidun. Is it that the false gods, the idols, apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are you taking and respecting and worshipping and leaving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then he asked this question, فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. What is your opinion? What is your, perception with the Lord of the universe? Brothers and sisters, this ayah or this question can also be asked to us, what is your real perception about the Lord of the universe? Do you see him as Ar-Rahim, Al-Kareem, Al-Aziz, or you see him as the sole reason for all the troubles that you have? Do you see him as a solution for your trouble and your problems, and as a ma'wa, where to run when you have trouble, or you see him otherwise? فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu says that wallahi alladhi la ilaha illa ghayra ma u'tiya mu'minun shay'an khayran min husni dhanni billah. He swears by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying that a believer has not been given something far much more better than thinking good, having good perception, having good opinion about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he continues saying, La yuhsinu abdun dhanna billahi illa a'tahu Allahu azza wa jalla. A person, a believer, will not think good, will not opine good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him that thing that he thinks good. Of course, for example, if you had asked something from Allah, knowing that Allah is al-mujib, he will give you. This is the statement of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Hadith al-Qudsi, he says, Ana inda dhanni abdi bi. I treat my servant, I take my servant the way he thinks of me, the way he perceives of me, the way he has, when you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able, he will treat you the same. When you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will aid you, he will indeed aid you. But when the opposite is also true, ana inda dhanni abdi bi, when you think that Allah will leave you alone, has left you, has, hajarak, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take it that way. To understand this more, brothers and sisters, look at this, or allow me to take you through these few examples. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam when he was migrating from Makkah going to Medina, of course, chased by his own people. On the way, he met Suraqa ibn Malik. And this Suraqa, after hearing about the prize that has been, you know, put there, that whoever brings Muhammad dead or alive, he will get this kind of treasure. He sees Muhammad wa sahibihi, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, and he tries to get hold of them. Of course, after several trials, which did not bear any fruits, he told the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that I'm promising you peace, and I'll never be in any army or any group that fights you. Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks at Suraqa and tells him, Kaifa bika ya Suraqa, idha labista suwarei Kisra. How amazing will it be, O Suraqa, when you will be adorning, when you will be wearing the crown of Kisra. Suraqa is like, you, Muhammad, people want you dead or alive. You are promising me that I will wear the crown of Kisra. And he asked, Kisra ibn Hurmuz? You know, like, he's not sure whether it's that same Kisra, the superpower that Muhammad is talking about, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Muhammad told him, Na'am, that one, Kisra ibn Hurmuz. To understand this statement, it's like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is telling him, I will reach Medina. And after reaching Medina, nobody will get hold of me. I will establish an empire, a community, and after some times, my community will conquer Kisra. And after that, you, Suraqa ibn Malik, will wear the crown of Kisra. This is, in short, what Muhammad is telling him, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He is very optimistic. He is very good, thoughtful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he will aid him, he will help him in this journey until he will reach his destination. In the same safar, or in the same hijrah, he with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu also had an instance in the cave. Abu Bakr, looking at the mushrikeen, they have reached the cave, is telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam that if any of them looked down his feet, lara'ana, he will get to see us. You know, they're so near, until he's like, between us and them is looking down. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, also having fiqh billah, very optimistic, he thinks good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells Abu Bakr, ma dhannuka bi ithnani Allahu thalithuhuma. What is your opinion, O Abu Bakr, of the two, me and you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the third of us? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then revealed the ayah that revealed the ayah that talks about if we are not ready to give him nasra, faqad nasarahu Allah idh akhrajahu alladhina kafaru thaniya thnaini idh huma fil ghar. This is how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam opined when it comes to his Lord Musa alayhi salam. Behind him is Firaun coming with the army. In front of him is the sea. The people who are with him are telling him, Inna lamudrakun, they'll get hold of us. Musa tells them, Kalla, they will not get hold of us. He has good fiqh billah. Inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdin, I have my Lord, he will of course guide me. These are but a few examples. Brothers and sisters, having good opinion when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can apply in many areas, but among them is inda dua. When you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you are doing dua, of course have that, assurance, or have that optimism that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer that dua that you are asking. Secondly, when you are in trouble, when you things are not going your way, when you have problems, also have thika billah. Think good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that huwa sayansuruk, He will indeed save you from that trouble that you are going through. Of course, He saved many. What is so big with that trouble that you are going through that you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not be there for you? And if you think He will not be there for you, that will be the case. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once entered the house that there was a very sick person. Then he told him, La basa tahurun, like telling him the dua, you will get better. Then this guy was like, tahurun? You are telling me I'll get better? Kalla. I mean, it's impossible. But it's an old man that Huma has taken, a good bit of him, and it will end with him to the grave, meaning I'll die out of this. You know, he has bad opinion about whatever he's going through and is not optimistic that Allah will save him. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then told him, فَنَعَمْ إِذَن. What you are saying, then it will pass. And they say he died out of that disease. And on the contrary, there was a boy also who was on his deathbed. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, how are you feeling now? The boy said, Arju Allah wa inni akhafu min dhunubi. I'm expecting good from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at the same time I'm afraid of my sins. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, looking at his optimism, he told him, or he said, these two things don't assemble in the heart of a believer, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him what he wants and will, of course, put him aside or away from what he fears. Aqulu ma tasma'un, subhanakallahumma bihamdika, wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Shukran, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.